I seen a murder at 4 years old right here.
I grew up in Third Ward, Calliope Projects. At the time, it's one of the most dangerous places in the world to live at. Most of the crimes that happen in New Orleans, probably half of it happened in the Calliope Projects. This is for real.
City of New Orleans and the hood's been at war since we were kids. I was in the military. I went to Desert Storm. What was the difference? The only thing, they just had bigger guns and missiles.
New Orleans has a record of homicides this year. It has by far the highest murder rate of any big city in the nation. 5 times the number of murders in cities of comparable size.
You know, me and my brother, Kevin, we used to sit in the projects and say, who gonna die first? If you live to be 19, you're an OG in the project. That was our magic number, man. If we could live to be 19, you know, we made it. And I mean, he died at that age, and that told something out of my heart. You know, when I watched my mom, her whole world turned upside down, and I'm like, I don't want to keep putting her through this. I have to do something better with my life. That's what really made me go hard with the music. You know, I named my company No Limit because there's going to be no limit to my success. And I named myself Master P because I said I'm going to master whatever I do. I mean, I was just Ice-T Colors. I am a nightmare walking psychopath talking. That music did something for me. You know, hearing a bounce music, it was a lot of party music, which was a good sound for New Orleans. But I felt like we was missing something. You know, seeing so many people die young, seeing the crime, seeing the poverty, you know, it just poured out me. I was able to tell my story.
I'm just talking about what I see. I mean, look around. You see a bunch of mansions around here? Do you?
No.
Okay, well, that's reality. That's what I'm talking about.
Grew up in the ghetto, raised by a killer. T-R-U across my stomach. Your neighborhood thug, nigga, trying to make it out this fucked up environment. When niggas die trying to make a dollar out of 50 cents, the ghetto got me crazy. I smell daisies, but I can't die tonight. More lady pregnant with a baby.
I built No Limit on $10,000. I put up my own posters. I went to every hood. I started taking my van and going from hood to hood, selling my CDs. That's the whole thing. I started selling it out of the trunk.
I mean, we'd be in D.C., and here's the thing. We wasn't supposed to be in D.C. That's like somebody, you know, going into Compton or whatever. We were just so about hustling, we didn't care about the dangers. That's all we have, so we here. And people was like, no, y'all just crazy enough to come in the neighborhood. You know what? Give me the CD.
So when I die, put me in a pine box, bury me like a G2 Glocks in a fucking bag of rocks.
No Limit, that wasn't no, you know, no bounce shit. You could hear hard life in their music, but that's a way of life in New Orleans. We gutter.